Hey, Prompt Masters, welcome back to our channel. Today, we're transforming our AI artwork into 3D models. Have you ever wondered what your favorite AI creations would look like in three dimensions? Well, wonder no more, because here's a fun open source tool that does just that. If you're eager to give this a whirl, you can find a Kaggle Notebook ready to go in the description and pinned comment below. And if you're feeling a bit daring and have a powerful graphics card, you might even want to try running the app locally. For this video, we'll be using a Jupyter notebook on Kaggle. To get started, just hit that run button next to the first code cell. Make sure your notebook is set up to use a GPU, turn on file persistence if you'd like, and ensure it has internet access. While the installation may take about 10 minutes, why not grab your favorite beverage and start dreaming up the perfect image for your 3D model while you wait? I'm assuming you already have your preferred way of generating AI images. And if you need a bit of guidance, we've got a selection of tutorials in our previous videos to help you create stunning AI artwork. Once the installation is complete, it's time to start up the web UI. Just click that run button and wait a bit for the models to download. When the app says it's running on a local URL, hit that long remote Mo link to launch the interactive web UI. Here you can either select from the sample images provided or upload your own creation. I'm itching to see our little cup logo in glorious 3D, so that's what I'll be choosing. Click Generate and let the magic unfold. You'll get 6 images, each showcasing the object from a different angle. In the current version, these will be overwritten every time you run the generation process. So, when you're happy with the output, either move to the next step or save a copy of the result. Now let's make that 3D model. I'll stop the UI and move on to the mesh generation step. We have 2 options here, and I'll go with Instant NSR for a more detailed result. Once this step is complete, you'll find a copy of the result in the Outputs folder. There's a bunch of files here, including a short video of the model in action. The mesh is stored in a OBJ file, and to view it, you'll need a 3D viewer or editor. I personally went with MeshLab, and you can grab it from the download link in the description. So, without further ado, here's how our cup turned out. There's definitely room for some touch-ups, especially when viewing it from angles not in the original image. But turning AI images into 3D objects with free software is a blast. I hope you'll have fun with this one, and I can't wait to see the incredible 3D creations you come up with. Thanks for hanging out today, and I'll catch you in the next video. Until then, keep creating and enjoy your 3D AI-generated world.